Foodpunkt Traveler für euch unterwegs in Nevada, USA. Ich bin Hannes und heute unterwegs in Fallon und ich treffe Kelly. Und heute geht es nur ums Gemüse. Das tut mir auch mal ganz gut nach dem vielen Fastfood, was hier passiert.
My name is Kelly Kelly and I am the Executive Director of the Fallon Food Hub here in Fallon, Nevada. So we're a nonprofit that works to educate our community about the values of eating seasonally and locally. And our goal is to increase market opportunities for produce growers and dairymen and ranchers. So today what we're going to do is we're going to pick a couple of different types of produce. I was thinking about harvesting some beets and some rhubarb and some asparagus. And then we're going to take all that produce and we're going to go back to the Douglas House here in Fallon and prepare a local food menu.
Wir gehen jetzt mal zum wilden Spargel. Auf zur Jagd nach dem Gemüse.
And we're going to kind of look for some of the big fat ones.
The big fat ones.
Yep. Yeah. The fatter they are, the more tender they are. So you're going to want to come down below the soil line and just cut it at an angle, like that.
Okay. Wichtig ist, den Spargel unter der Erde zu schneiden. Und die dicksten sind heute die größten Gewinner, weil wir sie für eine Spargelsuppe brauchen.
There you go. Perfect.
How many we need?
Oh, you know, we'll pick maybe 20.
20. Okay. Wichtig ist, dass man die Kumpels wirklich unter der Erde schräg abschneidet. Der Grund dafür ist, dann wachsen sie innerhalb von 2 bis 3 Tagen genauso wieder nach. So, that's enough?
You know what? I think we have enough. Next, I think we're gonna go off to the beets.
To the beets.
To the beets.
Let's go.
Even though we're in the middle of the desert, Fallon farmers grow a wide variety and an amazing amount of produce. So right now this is planted with all red beets.
Das ist wirklich biologischer Anbau. Überall ist so ein bisschen Unkraut dazwischen. Habe ich so auch noch nicht gesehen. Okay.
So yeah, we need to pick a couple of these beets and we're going to be roasting these off. We'll actually be chopping up the greens and we'll be sautéing those with garlic a little bit later. Let's see, I think we've got...
So liebe ich das, bei der Arbeit noch so richtig schön die Hände schmutzig machen.
So for me as a chef, part of my core philosophy is that I like using ingredients and products that are as close to their natural state as possible. And so for produce, produce that's grown here within a 5-mile radius of where I cook it, it is both more nutritionally dense, so it has more micronutrients in it. It's also grown by my friends and neighbors. It's grown, the varieties are selected for taste and for quality and not for mechanized harvesting. My local farmers, who I can come out and visit and I can walk on the farm, I can look at the rows where they're growing it, they're choosing carrots that are going to be the most delicious carrots you've ever eaten. And so for me, having that relationship with the people who grow the food that I cook is absolutely vital.
So where's the kitchen?
So we can just head straight back here. Straight, and then it's on the right.
Also hier geht's jetzt mal los. Guck mal diese geilen Farben. Ist das wunderschön?
So olive oil, salt and pepper. And then I have this chicken stock I made for you to right in between my 2 knuckles. What we have here, this is some local fennel that I cooked down with simple syrup.
Fennel with cinnamon and sugar?
And sugar and water, yeah. So that's gonna get mixed with...
That's my first dessert with fennel.
So we're gonna put this with the rhubarb and we're gonna top it with a mix of flour and oats and brown sugar and butter and kind of mix all together. Yeah. And we'll throw it in the oven and bake it until it's all bubbly and crispy on top. So now that's going to go right on top here.
Fett und Zucker. Love America.
Here we go, into the oven. Okay, so we've got the beets in the oven, we've got the lentils going, and the dessert is done. It's just got to bake. So, soup?
Yeah, why not? We do.
So this right here is a creamy asparagus soup.
It's good. It's same by Mama.
That's so nice.
Oh, it's good.
It reminds him of his mother's cooking. So, are you ready for some chopping? Okay. All right, so soup in first.
Guten Abend. Oh, damn, it's good. Okay, Mama, das ist wie deine Suppe. Einfach nur lecker.
Oh, yeah. Perfect.
Perfect.
So this is horseradish mixed with creme fraiche. If you don't have creme fraiche, you can use sour cream, but creme fraiche is better.
Let's go.
Hot.
It's from your oven.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Also jeder Apfelkuchen kann hier einpacken. I think it's time for a drink.
Sounds perfect to me.
Thanks.
Cheers. Oh yeah. Okay, thanks for cooking.
Absolutely, it was my pleasure.
Perfect. A nice experience. Thank you so much. Local food here in Fallon, absolut lecker, unbeschreiblich gut. Cheers. And I say thank you.
The pleasure has been mine.